As my 6-year-old daughter grew more curious about how things work, I started looking for a kit that is not just fun, but truly educational, after testing many STEM toys that overpromised and underdelivered, one stood out. The Crowbits Inventor Kit by Elecrow. Today, I am sharing my experience, not as a reviewer, but as a maker and a dad, hoping to spark a lifelong love of learning in his little girl. Let's start. I knew my daughter was ready for more than just playing with gadgets. She wanted to create, so I started looking for a kit to introduce her to programming and making. I believe building things with your hands is one of the best ways to express yourself. But for beginners, making can feel intimidating. If it is too hard at the start, it can push them away. So I was looking for something that strikes the right balance, easy to use, yet exciting enough to spark real curiosity in a child. I looked at everything, from simple toys to advanced electronics, but one stood out: the Crowbits Inventor Kit by Elecrow. What caught my eye was its thoughtful design, magnetic modules, a drag-and-drop coding interface, and a strong balance between structure and creativity. It even won a Red Dot Design Award, which is a big deal in the world of product design. As someone who used to teach STEM, I have seen how kids learn best through hands-on play that gives instant feedback and keeps things fun. Out of all the kits I looked into, this one felt like the best fit for my 6-year-old daughter. So I reached out to Elecrow and asked if they are willing to send me a kit, and they kindly did. Now, just to be clear, this isn't a sponsored video. They sent me the kit, but they didn't ask me to say anything. This is my honest experience as a maker, a teacher, and a dad, trying to help my daughter take her very first steps into the world of making. The kit costs around $140 with a microbit board included, or $120 if you already have a microbit board. I am not going to say whether that's cheap or expensive. I'll just show you what it includes, how it works, and how my daughter reacted to it. By the end of the video, you can decide for yourself if it is worth it. I actually opened the kit myself first, partly to film this footage for you, and partly because I knew that once my daughter got her hands on it, the box would be history. But more importantly, I wanted to take a bit of time to understand how everything works before introducing it to her. That way, I could guide her through it without confusion. And I have to say, right from the start, I was impressed by how well organized everything was. At the heart of the kit is the microbit board. That's the brain behind everything. What's great is that the microbit isn't just a controller. It also comes with built-in sensors, like an accelerometer, compass, light sensor, and even buttons and an LED display. So even before you connect any of the external modules, you already have a lot to work with. This opens up tons of creative possibilities, and it is a great way for kids to start learning how code can control real things. Then we get 10 modules, a solid mix of sensors, motors, LEDs, and the main controller. Everything is clearly labeled and color labeled, which makes it easy to understand what each piece does, even before opening the manual. This is the battery block, where we insert the microbit. Once it is in place, we can snap additional modules onto it. The magnetic connections are a big win. No wires, no frustration. Just a satisfying click as the blocks lock together. Right away, I could see how this kind of design gives kids the confidence to explore and experiment without the fear of breaking something. Along with the electronic modules, the kit includes a generous set of Lego-compatible building bricks, perfect for building creative structures around your projects. You also get 4 magnetic cables for more complex circuits and a printed instruction manual with 12 guided projects. But here is something important. These projects aren't your typical beginner tasks. Even the first one requires a fair bit of assembly and problem solving. There is no quick blink and LED win here. Instead, the kit jumps right into more advanced builds like an object-avoiding robot, a line-following car, a color sorting machine using the color sensor, and even a Bluetooth-controlled vehicle. These are exciting and educational projects, but younger kids will definitely need support, especially at the beginning. After unboxing everything, I decided to start with something simple, blinking an LED, just to get a feel for how the kit works before bringing in my daughter. I wasn't following the manual yet, just exploring. The magnetic connections made setup quick and frustration-free, which is a big plus. The software used is called Let's Code, and it is quite flexible. You can write code using visual blocks, similar to Scratch, or switch to text and write into MicroPython directly. Either way, the code gets translated into MicroPython and runs on the microbit, which is the brain of the kit. Blinking an LED was quick, just a matter of a few seconds. Next, I wanted to try something a little more advanced. I decided to connect the IR reflective sensor and write a simple program that will turn the LED on or off depending on whether it detected an obstacle. It was a great way to test how responsive the sensor was and how the input-output logic worked in the software. Within just a couple of minutes, I had it working. The LED will turn on when the sensor detected an object and turn off when it didn't. It was simple logic, but seeing it work so quickly was really satisfying. Everything responded as expected. From my very first impression, it was clear that this kit was thoughtfully designed. As a former STEM teacher, I could immediately tell that the people behind it understand how kids learn. Everything, from the layout of the components to the structure of the projects, felt intentional. It wasn't just a pile of sensors and instructions. It was a well-organized learning experience. The magnetic connections, the color-coded modules, the way each project builds on the last, all of it showed that educators and engineers worked together to create something meaningful. At that point, I felt ready to bring in my daughter and let her give it a try. Of course, I didn't expect her to write code on her own, she's 6, but that wasn't the goal. What I wanted was for us to work on the projects together. I would handle the technical parts, like setting up the code, while she explored the modules, snapped things together, and helped build the physical parts of the project. I was hoping to create an experience where she felt involved, curious, and proud of what we built as a team. And that's exactly what started to happen. We decided to build two of the projects together, an obstacle avoiding car and a line following car. These are both really fun and engaging builds, and working on them as a team was a great experience. My daughter helped with the assembly, explored how the modules worked, and was genuinely curious the whole time. Watching her excitement grow as we tested and modified each project was one of the highlights of this whole process. And the great thing is, now that we have got the basics down, we can go even further. The kit includes Lego-compatible bricks, and we already have a huge pile of Lego bricks at home. That opens the door to even more creative custom builds, combining coding with imaginative play. My daughter really loved this kit. She was curious from the start, asking what each piece does, trying different combinations and getting excited when something worked. It didn't feel like homework or a lesson. It felt like play, but with a purpose. The projects sparked her imagination and she started coming up with her own ideas. It was great to see her not just following along, but actually think and create. Now, is this kit perfect? Not exactly, but it is very good. It does what many kids fail to do. It sparks curiosity in kids without making them feel overwhelmed or afraid to try. The hardware design is excellent, honestly, close to flawless. The magnetic connections, durable components, and clear color coding make it really approachable for young makers. If I could improve one thing, it would be the project manual. The included projects are clever and inspiring, but many of them are a bit too advanced for total beginners, especially for younger kids like my daughter. A project that takes over an hour to build isn't the best starting point. I would love to see the projects organized by difficulty, beginner, intermediate, and advanced, and a few simpler, fast builds added at the beginning. Even though the kit is labeled for 10+, I believe with parent involvement and the right pacing, it can absolutely work for kids 6 and up. It just needs a gentler on-ramp to help them gain confidence before tackling the more complex builds. Still, overall, I'm really impressed. The kit gave us a way to explore programming and electronics together, and that alone makes it more than worth it. That was our experience with the Crowbits Inventor Kit. It's not perfect, but it is one of the most thoughtfully designed STEM kits I have seen, and it gave me a great excuse to build and learn along my daughter. If you are a parent, a teacher, or just someone curious about STEM education, I hope this gave you some insight. Let me know what you think in the comments.